The 2023 Global Series in Sweden, four teams, the Red Wings, Senators, Maple Leafs, and Wild.
One of the most exciting parts, being able to play in front of friends and family that really haven't been able to watch me play.
Do some team bonding, go to a couple of tourist attractions over there.
We want to have some fun too, but we remember, you know, what we're here for, and that's for 4 points.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to On the Fly. I'm Bill Pito, and it's great to have you with us. We begin with the Global Series in Sweden. For the first of four straight days of games in Stockholm, we got Detroit, we got Toronto, Minnesota, and Ottawa all involved. And game number one pitted Detroit against Ottawa, each team looking for its first two-game winning streak since mid-October. Let's take a look.
Stockholm will host games for four consecutive days, starting with this one tonight. Ottawa's the home team, and these are two teams that need wins.
Ottawa will head to the power play.
Tkachuk spins back along the board. Giroux, Kristoff alone in front, shoots. Kreider makes a stop, rebound, score! The puck was tipped in front of the shot by Batherson. Brady Tkachuk parked there, and Ottawa's got the opening goal.
I think Brady Tkachuk gets a piece of that completely by accident.
Stutzla. Austin Edge speeds it back and Tkachuk scores! What a feed by Stutzla, and Tkachuk's got his second. 10 goals on the year in 5 two-goal games.
The breakout gets a stick in on Stutzla, but Ben Sherratt, it's such a slow play. I don't think he expected it to come, and you can't just let it roll right through your feet to Brady Tkachuk.
So it's 4-on-4 now. Back at the point, here is Sanderson with it. Jake Sanderson plays that down to Tarasenko, center score! Sanderson from Tarasenko, and it's 3-0 Ottawa.
The Red Wings just don't throw it out. 4-4 generally man-to-man, and no one is really on anyone.
Chris Pass had to Tarasenko along with Josh Norris. In comes Norris for Joseph, back for Norris, shoots, scores! The Senators throw it around, and it's a 4-0 lead.
Got help there from Chychrun, hit his own man. Here's Raymond with Tkachuk back. Raymond along with DeBrincat. Raymond right in, he shoots, he's got! The local boy, Lucas Raymond. And yes, everybody loves Raymond here.
The goaltender, Corpusello, got a piece of it, but not near enough. And yes, they came out of their seats. Lots of mustard on the shot by Lucas Raymond, and that's the way to shoot the puck.
Moves it quickly to Mata, firing one that hit a body in front. Oh. Score!
Oh, what a bounce!
It's 4-2!
That might have gone off David Perron. Talk about getting a break.
Red Wings are in the midst of a change. Feeds it here. Gosses bear across it. Scores! It's a 4-3 game!
And DeBrincat is going to be the recipient.
Gosses bear wants it. Ottawa player falling on the play.
Oh!
And it's
gone! Oh, my God! Oh, my God!
In front for Kopp with Perron to the net. It's a tie game, 4-4! We're going to overtime. Circles up high with it, then gets checked by Tkachuk. And a race coming back. Tkachuk's got two. And a save by Reimer. Big stop on a Tkachuk breakaway looking for a hat trick.
Reimer has been really good after the score was 4-1. And made a lot of really big saves and allowed his team to get three more to tie the game. And none bigger than this one.
1-1 with Gostisbehere. Goes for Eden, shoots hard line up the end board to go. Sanderson drops it back. In comes Bamba with a pass across. Oh, the scores! He bats it in! Tim Stutzla with an incredible hand play. Wins it for Ottawa. Oh, what a goal!
He's got to wait for it to drop. And he does. Waist high, chokes down on the blade, more control, and bats it past a sprawling James Reimer. He's trying to find the puck. He didn't know what's going on. Oh, that's brilliant. Brilliant stuff.
Yeah, I think they got the bounces there and tied it up 4-4. That was really big for us to get that winning goal there. 2 seconds left. I think we had a lot of PPs today. Some not so good ones and some good ones, and it feels good to win that game. He got a great stick on it, and I knew it's not a lot of time left, so I just wanted to get it back on that, and lucky enough I hit it. I think our line wasn't playing good enough defensively, and we just got to get better at that, and we got to close out games better. I mean, we're at a 4-0 league. We don't need to score more goals. We just got to play good defensively, and Corby stood in his head there the whole time and kept us in the game, so we got to help him out. I knew a European fan's going to come out tonight, and yeah, a lot of Detroit fans, but our Ottawa fans were louder, I think, at the end, and it was good to have them here, and feel awesome to have that much support.
Stützle says he doesn't like to watch baseball, but he looked like a baseball player on the game-winning goal. He was the hero, scoring his third career OT goal in the win and becoming just the fifth player to score an OT winner in a regular season game outside of North America. He's the first player to do so since Mark Stone back in 2017.
These Penguins have been impressive.
Five-game winning streak. It's been because of their big stars.
And for the Penguins, what a night.
These guys are elite athletes, and they do still have it.
Places going bonkers.
Charlie has his third shutout of the season.
Blow the hats, Sidney Crosby. He's got the hat trick.
And the Penguins, who win their fifth consecutive game.
Pittsburgh is rolling since a 3-6 start. The Pens have reeled off five wins in a row, outscoring the opposition 25-8 in the process. The Pens hosting a New Jersey team that is having a devilish of a time without Jack Hughes, 1-3 since the star center went down with an upper body injury. The Devils and Pens from downtown in the Berg.
Erik Karlsson and the Penguins have turned their season around on a five-game heater. And now, a big test away tonight from PPG Paints Arena. The Pens try to extend the win streak to six in a Metro showdown against the New Jersey Devils.
One other area we'll have our eye on tonight is the face-off dot. These are two of the top six face-off teams in the league. McLeod gets it, and Jari denies it with the pad off a beautiful feed from Jesper Bratt.
It's a great opportunity right in front by Michael McLeod, but Jari, just no panic.
Slides it to Crosby, Pedersen gets it back, wrists it on, Vanacek, the save, rebounds there, oh, diving across, that may have bounced off Alex Holtz, either way it didn't go.
Great net front presence.
Here's Russ racing back, and backhand is scores! Well, he's not stopping that one. Brian Rust upstairs, and the Pens have the first goal once again.
All kinds of speed down that wing.
He is playing on the second power play, but still having an impact. Lazar, short-handed, shoots and scores! Curtis Lazar! Tie game!
Absolutely a huge goal, shorthanded by the Devils.
Built something right off the hop here. The Devils go out to center. Here's Jesper Bratt, tied for the team lead with 20 points. Moves around, calls it Bratt, and he's stopped by Jari.
The same exact save, too, but you see Jari just, you got to beat him to that post.
Passing for Karlsson on the backhand. Throws it to the net, save, and it deflects in. They score! The Pens go back in front as Karlsson put that to the goal. Did Brian Rust tap it in?
Amazing, through the legs of Gensel. But Rust is right there. That little touch, and it just squeaks through Vanacek.
Dougie Hamilton intercepts that pass. Nosek leaves it for Hamilton. He wrists it on, rebounds there. Second try, score! What an answer! Nate Bastian ties the game.
It's a nice drop pass from Nosek. Hamilton just fired that toward the net, and there's Nate Bastian on the rebound. He was celebrating like he got a stick on it, and that would be his first goal of the season.
Pass forward to Jesper Bratt. Now Luke Hughes, nifty work. Hughes feeds Bratt in the slot. Bratt pulls the trigger. He scores! Jesper Bratt puts the Devils ahead off the feed from Luke Hughes.
Still 14 seconds on the power play. Here's Malkin with it. Across, Smith rips it. Save, Vanacek.
He got all of that. What a save by Vanacek coming across.
Smith all the way across. Patterson cranks it, and Vanacek makes the save.
He rung the pipe as well.
Moves off a check, plays it behind. Here's a one-time score! Alexander Holtz from Dawson Mercer. Devils by two.
This is a thing of beauty. Picturesque.
Here comes Bratt to Toffoli, looking for more. He scores! Open up the floodgates. It's 5-2 Devils. Two goals in 20 seconds for the Devils.
And the Penguins just all kind of disjointed tonight on this power play. They need to score on this man advantage.
Puck squirts out to Crosby, and Vanacek shuts the door. An explosion here in the third period over a Pittsburgh team that was the hottest team in the NHL coming in, and they're back in the win column.
Yeah, I think that was
one of our best games of the season. You know, just the total team game. Like I talked about, after that, you know, that start, that first couple minutes, I think we really picked it up. And you know, a couple goals, you know, they went up 1-0 and 2-1, and we were able to kind of answer back fairly quickly. And I think that was huge. And we gained some confidence off of that. And overall, just really proud of the guys. The message in the locker room kind of after the second was, you know, how bad do we want it here? You know, we had lost three in a row, and so that's what it came down to, wanting it more.
So the Devils score three in the third. Pittsburgh's winning streak is over. Luke Hughes continuing his climb up the rookie point leaders list with another strong performance, recording two assists in the Devils' victory. As Hughes reaches the 10-point mark in just 15 games, only five other rookie defensemen in franchise history have reached the mark faster than Hughes. And all the more important, with brother Jack, Nico Hischier, and Timo Meier all out for the Devils because of injury. Next up for New Jersey, the Hudson River rivalry will be renewed Saturday as they face off against the Rangers for the first time since the first round of last year's playoffs. Both teams coming off of big wins, and there's a possibility that Jack Hughes might return to the lineup for the Devils. Everyone expected Vegas to be good this season, but Vancouver? Yes, the Canucks, perhaps the biggest surprise in the National Hockey League. Can they keep it rolling and pass Vegas in the standings? Find out next.
Now here's a lead pass. Quinn Hughes to win the game. Slams. Second time in his career, he's beaten the Islanders in overtime. The new captain wins it for the Canucks against the old captain. I'll tell you that for free. The Canucks take it 4-3 in overtime. The Canucks rally from two down, winning in overtime. They're 6-0-1 at home, and they are first place in the Western Conference. 4-3 Vancouver, the final.
The beauty OT winner from Quinn Hughes propelled Vancouver over the Isles Wednesday night. Entering Thursday night's action, Vancouver was 10-1-1 in its last 12. And as you see, it's magic in the standings. The Canucks were tied for the Pacific Division League with Vegas, which had lost three of its last four. We have the Golden Knights at Canadiens and Vancouver at Calgary. Let's begin now with the action up in Montreal.
Suzuki on the puck. He gets drilled by Eichel. Suzuki on his skates, able to free it. Wrist shot, score! Alex Newhook with the rocket, and it's 1-0 Montreal. First shot, first goal, Alex Newhook, four of the season.
Two hard steps out and a shot through a screen. Newhook puts Montreal on the board.
Newhook delays Harpoorks in front. Kovacevic, wrist shot, score! Jonathan Kovacevic, first of the season, 2-0 Montreal. He's had his looks all year long. Stone in the box for a minute 30.
Kicks to center ice to Kolesar. With help coming, Howden and Petrangelo. Howden, the rip shot, and he scores! Brett Howden sneaks it through Primo. It's a shorthanded goal, and Vegas within one.
And the Golden Knights right back in this one.
Ulinen chips it to center, trying to break it. He's got space. Jesse Ulinen to the forehand. Score! What a goal! Second of the season for Jesse Ulinen. Top shelf off the turnover. And the up 3-1.
Wrist shot hit McNabb. Second chance, score! And Brandon McNabb with his first of the year. And the Golden Knights in the blink of an eye have made it a one-goal game again.
Puck worked free to Ivan Barbashev. Barbashev not a Marchessault. Scores!
Jonathan Marchessault with a clear roof set. And the Golden Knights have pulled even at three.
Marchessault picks up his seventh of the season.
Back in for Pezzetta. Evans in front. Pulling it again!
A sweet dish by Michael Pezzetta from behind the net, right on the tee.
Yeah, the Golden Knights looking to pull even again. Eichel to Theodore. Wrist shot, score! Jay Theodore from out top on the power play, and the Golden Knights have tied the game at four.
Theodore around the wall to McNabb. Turned it over. Caulfield walking into the save. Hill! Aiden Hill has come up with some huge saves in the third period.
And the big man shuts the wickets.
Trying to get in front. Dorofeev loose, and Gallagher took him down, and a penalty coming up with 2:51 to go. Brendan Gallagher to the box, and Dorofeev slow to get up.
little conversation going on about whether this will be a 2 or a 4. There is blood on the ice.
Hey, there's no question this is going to be a double Meyer.
After a review, the call of the ice is confirmed. It's 4 minutes for high sticking.
And now a double Meyer to Brendan Gallagher with 2:51 left. Off to white goal. Rich shot, score! Jack Eichel snaps it home on a power play, and the Golden Knights have the lead with 1:56 left.
What a shot by Jack Eichel upstairs, glove side.
Now on their 7th power play, the most they've had in a game this year. And here's Carlson, now Stone behind it, and wraparound score! Mark Stone in tight, tucks it home to give the Golden Knights a little insurance. It's 6-4.
That reach of his stick to the far side puts it past Primo.
And Primo to the bench, so extra attack out. Across for Caulfield, makes his shot. Barrett, one-timer, score! Don't go anywhere yet! Justin Barrett buries one, 6-5 hockey game.
Lays a perfect pass to number 52, pounds it through Aiden Hill.
Monahan zips it out high, Matheson looking back, door! And Hill made the stop on Suzuki! Puck loose, Carlson intercepts, and that's it! And the Golden Knights hang on and pull it out in Montreal, 6-5.
Suzuki put that right into the mitt of Aiden Hill.
And the Golden Knights pull this one out.
Well, it's good to get 2 points. It's good to get it in regulation. Obviously, we had a lot of chances there in the third and the power play. It was kind of a weird game. I thought we played really well.
Our game plan was to play down low. Teams that are in these diamonds now taking away the elbow shots, even though Jack scored on one. But there were some crazy bounces, I'll say that. There were some interesting plays out there. And I said it this morning, I think things happen fast here. They do, and it just seems to be the way. And tonight was no exception.
I think we just kept shooting ourselves in the foot, turning the puck over a lot in the first period, second period too. You can't do that against a team like that, and they took it full advantage. They just didn't score in the first. Like I said, Preams made a lot of amazing saves. And the game could have been a lot different.
I know, but the game in Vegas, we deserve better, and today we deserve what we got.
So the Golden Knights extend their winning streak against the Canadiens to 6-0 with a win on Thursday. In those last six games, Vegas has outscored the Habs 27-19. They've gone 10-for-20 on the power play in that span. Now, let's check in on the Canucks and Flames in Calgary.
How about the leading scorers in the National Hockey League right now? JT Miller, Elias Pettersson, Quinn Hughes. They are 1-2-3 in league scoring. In fact, they're 1-1-1. The last time for this to happen, 26 points. The first 16 games for a trio of teammates, the 05-06 Senators.
Canucks are on the power play now. He's going to stay on the power play in the absence of Kuzmenko. Here's Hughes, Miller, Pettersson shoots. Easy goal. Markstrom never moved. Elias Pettersson into a wide open net. And the Canucks get another one on the power play and open the scoring. Points number 27. Were all three of them in on it? I think they all were.
Well, that one-timer just froze the goaltender. When you are hot, you are hot. Not only Pettersson, but the three amigos, Hughes, Miller, all contribute.
Around for Dubé. Nice little play off the boards. And away goes Lindholm with Greer. Lindholm, Greer, Weaver, scores!
Well, that's Dylan Dubé. Watch this exit and a great play by Dubé. The defenseman's going to pinch in. Now, nice passing here. Lindholm to Greer, and with Weegar also joining the rush. Beautiful shot off short side, beating to Smith. But this play does not happen unless Dubé makes that great play. And you know what? I don't think Dubé's even going to get a plus.
Nope. Well, Billy A stick time up. That allows the rock to work it through. Here's Greer off the wing. Throws a pass. Cross off the post. Rashid's going to lead of the game. Lindholm resets. Anderson takes a look, shooting. Smith makes the save. Puck on his goal! Dubé! One stinks through and he tucks it in. 2-1 Calgary.
All right, so Dylan Dubé will be rewarded now with the good play. Now Dubé does a nice play getting into the middle to Lindholm, and he loses sight of it, and Dylan Dubé comes right in behind. We couldn't see the loose puck behind the goaltender, but it was laying there.
DeSimone. Left point, Zadorov, wrist shot, and I think that changed direction. Oh, DeSmith slotted to his left, Rob Rizichka. What a save by Casey DeSmith. Wouldn't quit on that one after the initial shot changed direction.
We'll play some 4-on-4 with Rush Lakes off the bench for Calgary. Some tired Canucks, Coleman, Hannafin. Hannafin surveys, he'll cut in front, tries it, he scores!
What a great individual effort from Noah Hanifin. Great wheels. He's going to create all this opportunity because of his skating. A tap the net. He's going to get below the goal line. It may go off the stick of Pettersson. Yes, indeed.
Yep. Pass in front denied by Hughes, who got a stick of the way. Backlund. Here's a chance. Huberdeau scores!
But good pressure from the Backlund line. Starts really with Coleman down low. And there's Hronek. Not strong enough. The puck comes to Backlund. He spots Huberdeau, who we said had a great second period. And he converts as DeSmith goes down.
Works his way out from behind the net. Feeds the blue line. Myers long shot. Deflected in. Nils Höglander tipped it in under the bar. And Höglander gets the Canucks back within two with 9:54 to go in the third.
Shot of adrenaline here. This is fourth of the season.
Good stick there by Huberdeau, who gets it up. And there's an empty net goal for Lindholm. Huberdeau with the pass. Lindholm gets his fourth point of the night as they knock off the top team of the Western Conference with a 5-2 win over the Canucks.
You know, we're a good team. Just got to believe in ourselves, and that's what we've been doing, you know, the past five, six games. So I think it shows with the record. I think, you know, that was a pretty good team coming in tonight. The start wasn't perfect, but I think, you know, second period, we had a hell of a second period. I think we got under, you know, they were on a back-to-back, so we took advantage of that. And, you know, I think we got to believe in ourselves. That's the big thing.
So with the Canucks' loss, the Golden Knights find themselves back in sole possession of first. As for the Flames, they got big performances from some of their most important players in the win over Vancouver. Jonathan Huberdeau picking up a goal and an assist to mark just his second multi-point outing this season. Elias Lindholm recorded 3 points on the night after not finding the score sheet in the last five games. And Blake Coleman collected two helpers for his first multi-point game of the year. The Panthers are riding a five-game winning streak, but a tough opponent in the Kings. We head to L.A. after the break for highlights from this game and much more as we continue on the Fly after this.
Welcome to Svelia. We are now in the heart of Stockholm, everybody.
And they can't wait to drop the puck. Let's rock and roll.
Let's go!
We're going to overtime.
He bats it in. Tim Stutz a reach in for Ottawa.
Wow, shooting score. That goes upstairs on Jari.
Here's a one-time score.
This is a thing of beauty.
Comes Brat to Toffoli looking for more. He scores. Open up the floodgates. It's 5-2 Devils.
Surveys. He'll cut in front. He scores! Here's a chance. Huberdeau scores! Huberdeau puts it home for one Calgary.
Jonathan Marchessault with a clear roof set.
Jesse Ullinen doubles down. Second of the period. And Montreal leads again.
Stone behind the net. Rob Brown score! Mark Stone in tight. Tucks it home.
Don't go anywhere yet. Justin Barron buries one. 6-5 hockey game.
And the goal. Pulling out in Montreal, 6-5.
Shea Theodore had himself quite the game in the Golden Knights' win over the Canadiens. He scored a goal and had three assists to match a franchise record for most points in a game by a defenseman. He's the first D-man to record 4 points in a game for Vegas since Alex Pietrangelo did it back in March of 2023.
This is going to be a very formidable group when they get healthy, but they're not healthy and they're still winning games.
I never stop. Firing my soul on the stove top, maneuvering the scene when they close spots.
Carter Hagee, game winner. It's Reinhardt, the winner.
Smoke clears, and you see his image of a warrior. Victory is calling.
What a huge goal by the Panthers. They're up by two.
Because I'm on fire.
Carter Hagee scores.
The Florida Panthers with win number 5 in a row.
I'm on fire. I'm on fire.
Five straight wins for the Panthers has erased any potential concern about Florida's mediocre start. The defending Eastern Conference champs are rolling as they take the ice in L.A. against the Kings team that has been solid all season, going 6-1-3 in its last 10 games. Florida, though, hasn't won in L.A. since 2019 and is 0-4-1 in its last five matchups overall against the Kings.
Sends it up to Moore. Let it go to center. Here's Deneau with Fiala. Deneau to Fiala. In. Shoot. Scores. A minute 20 into the game. Kevin Fiala starts the scoring.
Well, I can't wait to get to our keys soon because that man right there is on the list. Over the pad, under the glove. The speed, the quickness, and the skill coming right at you.
Kings to center ice. Fiala for Anderson, moves in, his pass in front. Deneau denied!
The huge save on Deneau. And that's a big stop on the Kings centerman to keep this game at 1-0.
During first intermission, we had a parade of cancer survivors. We stand with all of those survivors and keep battling all the way.
So the Kings on their second power play.
No change yet, though, for the Panthers. They didn't get down the ice.
Here's Kopitar. Handing it off. Fiala to Kopitar, one-timer, score! 2-0 LA.
Getting clears all the way down the ice. The Panthers could not do it. The Kings will just really be creative here. Fiala, this pass is absolutely perfect.
Power play is 22 seconds left. Verhaeghe to Ekman-Larsson. To Tkachuk to Ekman-Larsson, a shot, save, rebound! Before Barkov to knock it in.
We'll see here with the Kings collapsing. Three Kings, four Kings, and Talbot.
Fiala got it ahead to Moore. Oh, Matthew Tkachuk stepped up with a big hit. In comes Deneau. Across for Fiala. In front, save Bobrovsky. Here's Moore shooting, blocked away. Tkachuk gave him another shot. Matthew Tkachuk getting physical here in the third. Reinhardt is in with Barkov. Barkov dragging it, getting to the net. Barkov stopped by Talbot. That might be the best chance of the night. Verhaeghe for Reinhardt, he scores! Sam Reinhardt has another one. The Cats are alive. It's a one-goal game with 8:15 to go.
Well, Reinhardt came in with that five-game point streak. Four goals in that five games, and he finally gets the Panthers on the board. Speeding in, Dubois to the net. Stopped by Bobrovsky, and Dubois shaken up.
Oh, it does not look good here. Oh, that's not a good sign.
Oh, he hits his legs on the post.
And it didn't move. That post didn't move. The net is empty. Puck out to the blue line. Now Verhaeghe, a shot blocked. Puck back out to Ekman-Larsson, shot blocked. Kings with it. We'll get a clear. There's the end of the game. The Kings hold on and defeat the Florida Panthers.
First and foremost, we knew we had to have a good start. They're a fast-moving team. They move the puck around, and they can score pretty much at will with that lineup. So we knew it was going to be a tough job to check them, and we did a heck of a job out there tonight, and our PK was absolutely amazing tonight. We just kept battling. It felt like they had possession for almost the whole 2 minutes a couple of those times, and we bent, we didn't break. We blocked some huge shots. Guys were sacrificing the body tonight, and we got some freezes and some ices when we needed it. So, I think our PK won us the game tonight.
40 seconds left on the power play. Horvat tip score! It's Anders Lee on the power play, set up by Bo Horvat.
What's that jumping into a tree, Brendan? That's a big monkey. He just got off his back and ran away. That's a perfect pass from Horvat, isn't it?
Power play number one for the Kraken. A look over the coverage, deal it back for Dunn. Veneers downhill with a shot. He scores! An absolute bullet by Matty Veneers on the power play. And the Kraken have tied it.
Gives up the outside right there over the blocker side of Varlamov. But what a read there by Matty. Stick in the lane.
The Kraken back to the power play. Dogging the puck. Bjorkstrand out in front. They score! That's hockey, baby! Alex Wenberg has goals and back-to-back games. It's a power play goal again, and the Kraken have a 2-1 lead.
Good battle down below the goal line. Bjorkstrand picks it up. Great feed. You thought that Bjorkstrand might even have time to take that out himself, but he threads the needle over to Wennberg.
Ryan Pulock trying to catch the Kraken in a chain. Barzal, Cizikas, he's in to the backhand and he scores! Casey Cizikas, and the Islanders have tied it 2.
That was a great transition play by the Islanders, and what a pass from Pletter over to Cizikas. Not always easy to beat the goaltender's 5-hole. They usually protect it with their stick, but Casey hangs on to it just long enough.
It's a pretty one for Casey Cizikas' 100th career goal in the National Hockey League. Done for holding, sets the Islanders right back on the power play. Here in the opening minutes of the third period, Dobson shot, score! Noah Dobson from downtown. It's on the power play, and it's 3-2 New York.
Oh, what a slap shot that was. He got all of that. That was a golf ball. It would have been out about 300 yards. What a shot by Dobson. Huge goal there. Gives the Islanders a 3-2 lead.
Power play for Seattle. Schwartz out of the corner. Yamamoto scores! Kyler Yamamoto to the roof. Power play goal. The Kraken have tied.
Nice feed here, out to Yamamoto, forehand, backhand, and into the back of the net. The power play's red hot for Seattle.
A Spokane special from Kyler Yamamoto. Here we go with Jordan Eberle, the former New York Islander. He scores! The Islanders need a goal to extend the shootout, and it's on the shoulders of Oliver Wahlstrom.
Stick side.
Scores! They needed it. Wahlstrom provided it. How about it? Kyler Yamamoto scores! Noah Dobson with a goal tonight. Slowly in on Grubauer. That's all! That's Kraken hockey, baby! The Kraken win the shootout.
8 rounds of the shootout. Kraken win it. Isles now 0-4-3 in their last 7. And Alex Wennberg picked up a goal in the win against the Isles, extending his point streak to 3 straight. Now has 2 goals and 1 assist in that streak. Prior to these last 3 games, Wennberg was pointless in 4 straight and owned a -2 rating. Let's now head out to San Jose as the Sharks hosted the Blues.
It is Hockey Fights Cancer Night. That is 8-year-old Quinn Bywater. She is a leukemia survivor, diagnosed at 4 years of age. She completed her last treatment 2 years ago. She's a big Sharks fan. Nice wave from a healthy Quinn. She's ready to go. They're ready to go. There's a save by Hofer. Now it's picked up at the point by Emberson. Sturm across. They score! Mike Hoffman! That's his second straight game with a goal. And it's 1-0 Sharks.
Everybody working together, all 5 guys up. Nico Sturm sells that he's going to the net, throws a beautiful pass across, and Mike Hoffman has the empty cage.
Ahotu. And that's turned over, and now Sundquist in alone for the Blues. Shoots, and it's saved by Kakinen.
Give credit to Kaapo Kakinen. Good blocker save.
Right off the bat, shoot that puck.
Here's Ahotu. And he scores! It's tipped at the front of the net, and the Sharks get off to a great start here in the second period. It's 2-0. William Eklund will get the goal. Here's Burrows. He'll lob it down into the corner. Carpenter up the middle, cut into Smith. He scores! Giovanni Smith, his first goal as a Shark. It's 3-0.
Everybody went crazy down here on the bench. Sharks up 3-0, and it's nice to see Giovanni smile.
Giovanni Smith, the 300th different player to score a goal with the Sharks. Going back, here's Cunning. He scores! That line does it again. Luke Cunning has a 3-game goal-scoring streak. Sharks up 4-0. Here's Neighbors, and it's blocked by a hook. A lead pass for Hoffman. He's in the left. That scores! Mike Hoffman. And it's 5-0.
Mike Hoffman, quick wrister. Look at that stick flex. Absolutely beautiful.
Hayes out front. And Granlund trying to find it. There's a great save by Kakinen. And another 2 out.
outstanding stops.
Puck bouncing all over the place. Churn shot. That means that's such a tough shot to pick up.
Buchnevich's shot and a glove saved by Kakinen. He's seeing it all tonight.
He makes it look easy, but it's difficult because there's people in front.
Kakinen can fly.
Yes, he can.
Thomas across, and Kakinen comes up with the save. Kaapo Kakinen having his best game of the season so far. Thomas a pass back. Here's Paul. Shoots, and he scores! Falk let it go, and it's 5-1. The Blues finally break through as Buchnevich gets his fifth of the year. San Jose Sharks with their most impressive three periods strung together, and Kaapo Kakinen picks up his first win of this season and his first since April of last year with the Sharks.
So the Sharks get their third win of the year, 5 goals from them, the most in a game this year, and the star of the contest was goalie Kaapo Kakinen. Kakinen stopped 44 of 45 shots faced, earned his first victory of the season. Also, just the second time Kakinen has made that many saves in one game in his career. Up next, Connor Bedard having a stellar start to his rookie season. Could he keep it rolling with Chicago against Tampa Bay? Find out as we continue more on the Fly after this.
Took his eye off the puck, and guess who? Connor Bedard scores! Bedard takes the puck, scores! What a goal by Connor Bedard!
Unbelievable by Connor Bedard. Not even looking. He makes the goaltender, Bobrovsky, think that he's going to pass it.
And you see the skill level of Connor Bedard. 8th goal of the season. The rookie sensation.
In 6 straight games.
Panthers get caught in the change, and that whole side opens up in just enough time for the speedy Bedard to come in, and then he picks the far corner.
Sports history is littered with number one overall draft picks who do not live up to expectations. Trying to project who will be a franchise fixture is far from an exact science. But so far in Chicago, Connor Bedard has been as good as advertised. 13 points in 13 games and 4 goals in his last 2 games, including a 2-goal, 2-assist performance against Tampa Bay last Thursday. Bedard trying for another strike against the Lightning in Chicago.
Here's Bedard, he's 1-on-3 again. Kurashev to the corner, he is belted, and players come together.
And as Sergachev waits for it, that is Bedard that's in there first, and the rest of the red jerseys come flying in as well.
Hagel on it, centers through, with speed, Cirelli, shorthanded, big save, Peter Mrazek. To keep it scoreless.
Maybe what we needed was a Blackhawk power play. Chances at both ends there. Right.
Blackhawks haven't been able to really set things up. Corey Perry will go net front presence. Gorchinski swings it off. Looking for the redirect and the score! It's Lucas Reichel! His first goal of the season comes on the power play. And it's 1-0 Chicago.
Nice job last year, or the year before last in Chicago here.
Cirelli blocked that shot. And we'll see how he's doing.
This probably isn't great if he goes back through that door into the tunnel, but here he is right in the middle of the ice, and oh, he gets that, it looks like, on his hand.
Anthony Cirelli is not returning tonight's game. We saw him left in that second period after blocking a shot.
He's got to be on the body, and he has been.
Oh, what a move. Corey Perry in and couldn't finish. Corey Perry still got the hands. Loose puck. Scramble for it. Dickinson got the shot away. Stopped by Johansson.
Perry gets it into the crease, and he and Kachuk are chipping away at it with Dickinson. That's going to be a delay of game penalty here for the Blackhawks.
Back to the point there. There's Kucherov. Point in the bumper. Paul net front presence. Hedman lets it go. Shot to score. Braden Point on the power play.
This looks a lot like Lucas Reichel's goal in the first period for Chicago.
And the Lightning have tied the game at 1. Chernik will roll up for it. Goes off the stick there of Phillips. Lightning have set up pretty well here. Sergachev shot, score!
goes through a maze of players and in. And for the first time tonight, the Tampa Bay Lightning have the lead, 2-1. Connor Murphy had a big hit. We're going to get a scrap. Connor Murphy and Michael Esamont going at it back behind the play. And Esamont looking to stick up for his teammates there. Kucherov tried the one. Thomas, Chicago looks to counter and bring. Corey Perry has got some help. Trying to swing it across in front center. Tic-tac-toe. And it's Corey Perry who finishes off a brilliant Chicago setup. And the Blackhawks have tied the game at two. One touched it across the line. Hagel's got some space. Floats one towards the front of the net. Centered and nearly put in off of Connor Murphy. Close call for Chicago. Cross for Hedman. Goes back. Chernak in traffic. Mrazek never saw it, and the bounce off the end boards, and it's in. Victor Hedman has put Tampa Bay on top. Back on top with 8:07 to play. Extra attacker on for the Blackhawks, and shot right back out. Hagel with an empty net, and he'll flip it top of the net for the goal and the clincher for the Tampa Bay Lightning. Chicago falls 4-2.
You know, not scoring a goal in, you know, two straight games is it's not really a confidence boost. So, you know, for us going here, I thought we played overall a pretty solid game, and you know, we're able to capitalize on some chances. And yeah, I just thought we played a really good role game, and we're able to win the game.
And Vasilevsky is coming back any day now. Like, what does that mean to you? How can you describe that?
No, I mean, best goal in the world. We're obviously super pumped about that, but you know, we can't take anything for granted when he comes back. But you know, it's going to take a while for him to get used to it. But you know, Jonas and Maddie has given us a chance to win every night, and you know, we've been very fortunate to have those guys. So you know, still early on, but we're you know, 7-6 now, so you know, we'll take it.
Andre Vasilevsky's been out with a back injury. Tampa Bay snaps his three-game losing skid. No points in the game for Connor Bedard. But for Tampa Bay, Braden Point collected a goal and two assists in the win of the Blackhawks to bring his season point total to 21 points. A lot of points and Point in all of this. Point becoming the second Lightning player to reach the 20-point mark this season, joining Nikita Kucherov. The last time the Bolts had multiple 20-point scorers through 17 games in a season was back in 2017-2018. Now, let's check in on the Coyotes and the Blue Jackets in Columbus.
So we're ready to go here tonight in Columbus as the Coyotes and the Blue Jackets meet for the first time.
Of course, the lavender color, the lavender ties, lavender in the rink, synonymous with Hockey Fights Cancer Night.
This is a great initiative, not only by the Blue Jackets, but the entire NHL.
Now Stetcher in the slot, shot from the wing, a scramble with Berzlikens down, the puck drilled Elvis without his goal stick.
Coyotes tried to go to work. You can see this mad scramble. Elvis is on his belly, and as he gets up, he makes a remarkable save.
Puck sent to the point, D to D, now Severson looks into the slot. Laine could not connect.
Patrick Laine not happy here on the bench, a little frustration. Here he's trying to work on the stick a little bit, finally breaks it, hands it back over his shoulder. He says, let's get a new one here.
Minute 36 left in the Cooley minor.
Runner right to the line, turnover here. Barrett Hayton goes back the other way, short-handed. Hayton is in, he shoots.
Elvis looks behind him and covers up.
How did that stay out of the net? Quick snapper, tries to go five-hole. Oh, man. I think it was stuck between the mattresses, those pads, as he squeezes tight there.
Provorov is the Jackets keep the puck in the offensive zone. Here's Drogan, scores! Severson, how many times in recent games have we seen the Jackets fail to score in the power play and then come right back seconds later? And here's another one. 1-0, Severson.
Schmaltz with a couple opportunities now. He's starting to feel it.
In front, they scored! It's Barrett Hayton! And the Coyotes have tied it at one.
A great job by this top unit all over the Columbus Blue Jackets. They're bringing the heat. Barrett Hayton is second of the year. That is a huge goal for the Coyotes.
Keller turns. He brings it in. Keller right to the net. Keller upended. Penalty coming up here. And the Coyotes will go to the power play.
Again, Clayton Keller. Are you kidding me? Taking that to the cage.
They had one shot in their previous attempt.
As Cooley will play it. Shoots. He scores. And the Coyotes with a power play goal.
The Pittsburgh native Logan Cooley's made it 2-1.
And the Jackets' string of 23 straight kills over 10 games comes to an end.
And they score again, and it's Lawson Crouse and the Coyotes with a 3-1 lead.
They force a turnover. It's Bukestad all over it. What an effort by Bukestad.
And Merzlikins has seen enough. He snaps his stick.
Six skaters on. The Blue Jackets in. Texier deals the point. Cross ice. Severson with a shot. Scores! David Severson, who scored earlier, has cut the deficit to one. And there's a minute 57 left. Final seconds. Marchenko trying to keep away from Durzi. Over the stick of Zach Werenski.
And that's going to do it. And the Coyotes with another 2 points. And Connor Ingram, five straight in the win column.
Break up the Coyotes as they get the win. They go 1-for-2 on the power play, and that power play is rolling. Coyotes have netted 9 power play goals on 21 opportunities over the last 7 games, and they've scored at least one power play goal now in 7 straight games for the first time since January of 2014. Time now for our Top Shelf plays of the night.
Here's Russ racing back in, backhand, and scores! Well, he's not stopping that one. Brian Rust upstairs, and the Pens have the first goal once again.
Trying to break in. He's got space. Jesse Ullinen to the forehand. Score! What a goal! Second of the season for Jesse Ullinen. Top shelf off the turnover. And the Habs up 3-1.
Huge beat. Bratt in the slot. Bratt pulls the trigger. He scores! Jesper Bratt puts the Devils ahead. Off the feed from Luke Hughes.
And look at Bratt again. He opens up those skates. Little deception, protects the puck, and he roots it.
And Theodore out high. Off to Eichel. Rich shot, score! Jack Eichel snaps it home on a power play. And the Golden Knights have the lead with 1:56 left.
What a shot.
Barzal, Cizikas, he's ahead to the backhand, and he scores!
Casey Cizikas, and the Islanders have tied it 2.
It's a pretty one for Casey Cizikas, 100th career goal.
Monahan zips it out high. Matheson looking back. Door! And Hill made the stop on Suzuki!
The left arm of Aiden Hill as he comes across. Wow.
Here comes Matheson to pass it. Oh, he scores! He bats it in! Tim Stutzel with an incredible hand play. Brings it for Ottawa. Oh, what a goal! Slick.
It's an original six throwdown.
Puck is picked up. Here's a chance. Batherson tries to send it in front. Bouncing puck. Oh. Scores! Out of midair. Tim Stützle buries it. Ottawa wins it with 2 seconds remaining in overtime.
What a huge extra point for the Ottawa Senators and the youngster Tim Stützle. Oh my gosh. It's like he had a paddle tennis racket in his hand, Dean, as he swatted that puck about a foot and a half off the ice.
A great first game in the Global Series, and it resumes Friday in Stockholm with the Leafs facing off against the Red Wings at 2 p.m. Eastern. You can catch that game right here on NHL Network, along with 2 more coming your way this weekend with the Wild and Sens on Saturday at 11 a.m. Eastern, and an even earlier start Sunday when the Leafs and Wild drop the puck at 8 a.m. Eastern time. Time now for our 3 stars of the night. Number 3 star, Braden Point, who recorded a goal and 2 assists in Tampa Bay's 4-2 win over Chicago. It also marked Point's second 3-point performance of the season. Our number 2 star is Shea Theodore, who collected 4 points in the Golden Knights 6-5 win over the Canadiens. Theodore also matched a franchise record for most points by a defenseman in a game. And the number 1 star, Tim Stützle, who scored the OT winner and collected 2 assists in the Sens 5-4 OT win over the Red Wings in Sweden. It's Stützle's third 3-point performance of the season. So that's going to do it for this edition of On the Fly. I'm Bill Pito. Thanks so much for watching as we leave you now with some of the best images from Thursday night.
Good evening, hockey fans, and welcome to Avicii Arena in Stockholm, Sweden.
Vacation mode over, game mode activated.
Oh,
well, look who it is, Bryce Harper.
How big is this? The age of 19.
He takes a big hit. Murphy and a big hit. We're going to get a scrap.
Look at a stick up for his teammates there.
And hell about the stop.
The speed, the quickness, and the skill coming right at you.
Hockey Fights Cancer throughout this entire month of November.